And good morning. Glad to see you this morning. Glad to have Pat McGuigan with us, as we do every Saturday morning. And Pat, I know that we have talked, it seems ad nauseum, about pension reform, but it just happens to be one of the most important topics there at the Capitol this session. For people who can't follow it as closely as you do, what happened this week with pension reform?
I guess my preface would be, Justice Antonin Scalia once in a decision said, some issues present themselves as a wolf in sheep's clothing. This issue presents itself as a wolf in wolf's clothing.
Yeah.
It's a big issue. We have talked about it a lot. This week there was some significant forward movement because the Senate passed the House version of the bill that requires that if you're going to have a COLA, cost of living adjustment for public employees in the pensions, that you have to fund it. Well, that seems, again, like a pretty straightforward concept, but we haven't been doing that as a state. We've been increasing COLAs and then not paying for them. To race through quickly, here's the fundamental things to remember. 61% is the average of the funding of the six Oklahoma state government public employee pension funds. Adequacy in the private sector is 80%.
Right.
And meaning if you project all your liability, you need to be at 80%, you can manage that other 20. It's better to be higher than 80, but
right,
that's adequacy. Here's the kinds of terms I hear from Oklahoma elected officials in both parties. Ticking time bomb. The potential for liability to double and triple if the return on investments in those pension funds is not at least at 7.75 to 8%. If it's 6% or lower, which can happen, even in a decent economy, you can have bad return. Looming crisis level. Looking back at the past, terms like lack of responsibility in decision making. And of course, the one I thought was the most dramatic was Senator Massey of Tulsa saying, this is the one that could implode us. Okay, so what's next? What does all this mean? This is a first step, and if Oklahoma doesn't address this issue and begin to address it now. It might be unreasonable to say we've got to solve the whole issue this year, but if it doesn't begin to be addressed significantly now, we are leaving a nightmare for our children. I can't say as an analyst exactly what all the right outcomes are. I can just say that pension reform has to be addressed in Oklahoma, because if it's not, there's every single person who pays taxes and everybody who cares about the future of the state will be affected if we don't address it.
To a large extent, you're going to grade the entire session on what they do on pension reform.
Yeah, there's certainly not going to be a grade higher than B- if there's not, I'll just go ahead and say it.
Yeah.
It's like a professor at the midterm saying something, you know. I'm not being pretentious on that. It's just if they don't address pension reform, they will not deserve a high grade for this session, and that's Republicans, Democrats, the governor, and the legislature.
Something else that's been in the news a bit lately, people may have paid attention to, the issue surrounding Sardis Lake, and really tied into that is the bigger issue of water use in Oklahoma, and there's a comprehensive water use plan that's being developed right now, and we're kind of nearing the end of it. I think it's been a 5-year process, and now they're doing these public hearings essentially across the state?
Yeah, they're presenting the draft comprehensive water plan. They started out in the Panhandle in Beaver. And Panhandle's probably a good place to begin a discussion of water. And that was on Tuesday. In the coming week, down in southwest Oklahoma, Lone Wolf, and then larger towns, Clinton on the 27th, Enid on the 28th. Tulsa's meeting will be on May 3rd, Oklahoma City's on May 26th. What kinds of questions? Is there enough water? How should we use the water? What are the issues in different parts of the state? And of course, you have heavy agricultural use in some parts of the state, and you have heavy manufacturing, industry, and residential use in other parts of the state, and everybody can figure out what those are. Subsets, very important subsets, is like the Sardis Lake issue, where Oklahoma City paid the state's fee to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers last year, kind of a significant development. And that reinforces their right to have the storage of a bucket of water. That's the analogy I've heard. But then if you try to use it, the tribes might say, the large tribes might say, wait a minute, you can't use that until we are part of the deal. Now in 2001, both the Choctaws and the Chickasaws said that there was enough water flowing downstream and in the wells in Oklahoma that everybody can win. 2011, they're taking a different position, and they're very much asserting sovereign tribal rights to the water. That's a very challenging issue, and it's going to be fascinating to watch it unfold. The only thing I would say is that in Oklahoma, under Oklahoma law, the water belongs to the people. Kind of interesting. Almost a very different kind of model than what we're used to in robust free enterprise. So the water belongs to the people. Well, who are the people? Well, we're pretty diverse, and we have separate interests, just like in the private economy. So at the end of the day, tribal rights, the prerogatives of the states, the state, the people in general, how does that all get resolved? The rural future, which is very dependent on water, our common future. That's what this is about. So in a way, it comes back to almost the same kind of issue as pensions. It's a wolf in wolf's clothing, and it's going to affect the future of our children and our grandchildren.
It's going to be a big issue going forward for us.
It's going to be real big, and within a month, we'll have a pretty good idea of at least what the Water Resources Board thinks is going on.
All right, Pat, thanks so much. Of course, you can read more about these and other issues at capitalbeatok.com. Pat, thank you very much. We'll see you next week. Have a great day.